ICT Academy, and Director Mr. Santosh for calling me to be part of this event. I think it's a great initiative at these times. Anyway, the order is good. You had the other speaker talk about the challenges that are there. And for a large group here who are students and teachers, I think you need to look at every challenge as an opportunity. So when he listed out seven challenges, in each of those challenges you will find a lot of opportunities that are there. It's up to each one of us to identify what these are and how do we take it forward. When you talk about the fourth industrial revolution, recently we had a talk in Trivandrum by Professor Ramcharan, and actually I have a small 3-minute video that on my Facebook page, but very interesting thing which he said is that when a company fails, with every industrial revolution some businesses fail, when a company fails, it does not impact that company alone. It actually impacts the place where that company operates from. It impacts the country where that company operates from. And most of all, it impacts the employees who work in that company. This is something which is very, very important. And when we look at it as we go forward, a lot of you, as you are part of the ICT Academy, are looking at information technology sector in India, which today employs about 40 lakh people, 39 to 40 lakh people. And if you read the newspapers regularly, which I think today's generation doesn't do much, okay, if you read the newspapers or even if you go through online and look at what's happening, there are a lot of threats which are talked about. Okay, you talk about what's happening with Trump, you talk about what's happening with the changes in technology, and then you're talking about the McKinsey report which was quoted earlier. So I'm going to not scare you, but the McKinsey report talks about 65% of India's workforce today needs to be retrained, which means we are talking of a very large number of people who have to be retrained. Further down, they say that 40% are not retrainable. If 40% of the industry that we are in today is not retrainable, you are indirectly saying that about 16 lakh people, 1.6 lakh people may not, who are in the industry today, may not have a job. Does that impact you as students? No. Does it impact people who are in the sector? Yes. But because they've said this, and because we know this over the last, it's not that today morning somebody's coming to say that there are no jobs for 16 lakh people. What is happening in this sector, and there is another interesting thing is the industry going to have less than 39 lakh people working? No. The industry will have more people working. You have people from industry who are here who are continuing to recruit. All right. So very clearly the opportunity is there. But there are challenges. And how do we seize them is a big question that is there. So when you look at it today, in the past, if you completed your engineering in 98, 99, you needed to know mainframes, you needed to work with mainframe computers, you needed to know how to solve that thing of making, you know, 2 digits year to a 4-digit year and things like that. That continued for a long time. Even today, there are people who work on mainframe computers, who know the technologies which are required for mainframe computers. So it is not that everybody who was there during that, in the early years of 2000, actually lost their job. No. But there are changes which happened. How did many of the others survive? They continue to learn. They continuously learn to move into other areas. Which is what I think students who are here, and even more, those who are in education institutions, the teachers and the management need to realize, that the times when you could teach something and expect that this is what the person would learn till the end of their life, or do for the end of their life, is over. You heard what Mr. Radhakrishnan talked about earlier. Dr. Radhakrishnan said, 1 year. During his time, it was 10 years. In my time, it was about 10 years. But as we move forward, even then, there are things which were very important. Like, for example, we were lucky that when we studied for engineering, we could see a steam engine. Okay, but I know that 10 years after I completed my engineering, they were still talking about the steam engine when there were no steam engines running in this country. So the academic heads have to ensure that syllabuses need to change. And we need to start making changes, and we have to be agile there. Those who are in the software industry understand what agility is. But the biggest threat there comes from the academic community themselves. The teachers don't want to change. They have a job, and as long as they can teach from the notes that their teachers taught them with, they are happy. The students don't know and don't realize that what they are learning is not going to be useful. I can tell you today that those of us who have children, or who have relatives, or we have friends who have children studying in classes 10 and 12, many of those children will never use, or will never be able to use, what they are studying today when they get onto a job. Those of you who are studying for engineering, you will find that less than 5% of what you learn will be useful for you. What is important in today's times is that you need to know how to continuously learn. Continuously learning is probably going to be the thing that is there. So there is no point in saying that I'm a Java expert, or I know there's somebody from Oracle here, I know Oracle. Okay, or I know a relationship-based database. You need to know how can you learn what Oracle comes out with tomorrow in such a manner that you are able to move with the times. The other one, and I heard somebody talk about this recently, he said, look, he has a 10-year-old, 11-year-old son. And he says, my son, and I'm sure that I have two grandsons, they may never take a driving license. And they may never own a car. Because it may not be required. The world is changing. Now you heard the earlier presenter talk about the drivers in Barcelona. So one of the things which is even more important for people like us who are within Kerala, we need to know that we should not be resisting change. All right? We have to look at the opportunity within that change and move with that, or try to overtake it. Because only then are we able to ride on that wave of change and succeed. So when you look at it, the companies that you had in the Fortune 500 list 40 years ago, hardly anybody is left. Those who are there today, you will see hardly anybody 10 years from now. That thing is changing very fast. So when you look at this, it's very clear that you have to continue speaking. Now, you heard Rishikesh talk about artificial intelligence, talked about machine learning. All these, it is not necessary for you to be able to learn those in college. It is also not necessary for you to pay high fees and go to some place where they will teach you how to learn machine learning. A lot of it is today available on the net. It's available free of cost. I just think of how the times changed. When Technopark was being set up in the early 90s, incidentally, this hall has not changed for nearly 20 plus years. Okay? Yes, to some and others, those tables are the chairs, same. The chairs have changed. The ceiling has not changed. Okay? This on the side you can make out has not changed, but nobody will think it's about 25 years. Okay? It's been maintained well. But things have changed. When we started, there was a very interesting board at the Karyavattam Junction. Those who know this place know, there's a very interesting board. We'd say, Indian Institute of Computer Programming, Data Entry, and Photocopy. Okay? So this was what was a big business at that time. Okay? It said, Indian Institute of Computer Programming, Data Entry, and Photocopy. All that was there was he actually had a photocopy machine, and you teach somebody data entry, all right? Those times have gone, all right? And they moved. I think that board changed very fast. So one of the things you have to be very careful about is you will suddenly find somebody coming up with an institute of machine learning in a small corner of the city, and then, you know, typical of Malayalis, we're just waiting here. I'm talking about the Kerala because a large number of people here are Kerala. We are just waiting and say, please come and cheat me, all right? So this guy has learned something, so he goes to the web, he learns something, he has a course which is there, and then you go and then you tell your father or your mother, so 40,000 rupees for this course. It's a 6-month course. Okay, so you go there and then, you know, then they say you have to actually, to learn machine learning, you have to start from MS Windows. Okay? And then they tell you you have to learn. So because I remember this, because there was one training institute in Trivandrum years ago when MS Office was coming out. They had a training program and they said, first you have to learn WordStar. Then, because that is what he had at that point of time. Then you have to learn something called WordPerfect, okay? Which nobody hears about now. Then we will teach you Microsoft Word, all right? So this whole course went on for about 3 months and people paid 10 to 15,000 rupees fees for it. So please don't get carried away by that. A lot of this you can learn yourself. MOOC is there. You can go, you get the best faculty from around the world. This is a big challenge for our faculty also today. Because smart students know that tomorrow this is what my teacher is going to teach. The teacher has not heard that lecture which somebody in Stanford or somebody at Harvard has given. And then they come, the teacher starts teaching. The teacher is using some textbook which is 2 years old. And then the student gets up and asks a question which they got from yesterday's lecture. Right? And then there is a conflict which happens. Also, unfortunately for us, the best, no disrespect to those who are teachers here, but the best of our people, except for a very small percentage of the teachers who are there, have taken up the teaching assignment because they could not get another job, okay, which is not good. So I think those who run education institutions, if you don't get in the best people as your teachers, it is better not to have those teachers. Okay, it is a crime to do that. And I normally say that in the secretariat, you may have a clerk or an IAS officer or a joint secretary, whoever. If they are bad, that file goes through 10 people, one of them will correct it. But if you have a bad teacher, a generation is finished. So many of you hate biology because you are a terrible biology teacher, or you hate mathematics because you are a terrible mathematics teacher. So it is very important for teachers, if you don't like the profession, please don't take it up. If you take it up, you have to be current and you have to be also continuously learning. So what is important for you, and I will leave with that message because I know we are running out of time. One, continuously learn. You have to learn how to continuously learn. Among yourselves, if there are 5 of you, you say, look, these are the topics, you learn this, you learn this, you learn this, you learn this, let's come back, we do it together. Collective learning is important. In the past, we used to call it combined study. All right? So it is important that you do collective learning. People will learn in depth, come back and talk to the others. It's collect. You learn together, you do it in groups. Big thing, you learn also to work in groups. Right? The other thing which is very important today, and I will conclude with that, is one, continuous learning I talked about. The earlier structure, those of you who work in industry today, where you had multiple layers, is gone. All right? Most project managers don't have a job today. All right? And 20 years, 10 years, 5 years, 4 years ago, when you walked into a room, they respected you because you had 10 years of experience, 15 years of experience, and you were their project manager. Today, when you walk into a room, they look at you and they respect you if you know what is to be done, how it is to be done, and if you're adding value to the work that they do. So it is necessary to have continuous learning happening. And this is a big challenge for those who are in the age group above 35. They find it very difficult to continuously learn. But I think companies are making efforts to tell them you better learn, otherwise you have a problem. Thank you very much, and we'll take on questions as we go forward. Thank you very much.